Hello friends, happy new year to all, hope you're doing well. So let's jump into some latest space updates. Today we'll start with SpaceX's first launch of 2023 that delivered 114 payloads to orbit in a Rideshare launch. SpaceX had just completed 2022 with a record-breaking count of 61 launches. They'd never launched a rocket after December 23rd till the year end, that put an end to SpaceX's record-breaking performance in the last year. Recently, with the Transporter 6 launch, they've marked the first launch of 2023 and nailed the 200th successful flight of Falcon 9 rocket. This launch also marks SpaceX's Transporter missions as an affordable launch option for space startups that in turn help many cottage industries to develop. As for 2023, Musk had set a goal for SpaceX to carry out up to 100 launches, indicating that 2023 will become far more thrilling than 2022. As per reports on Tuesday, the 3rd of January, 2023, at 9:56 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the Transporter 6 mission was launched aboard a Falcon 9 rocket from the Space Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. According to sources, the mission was supported by Falcon 9 booster B1060. After landing, the booster marked the 161st successful landing in an overall. SpaceX wrote in mission description that, "This was the 15th launch and landing of this Falcon 9 stage booster, which previously supported launch of GPS-33, TurkSat-5A, Transporter 2, Intelsat G33 and G34, and 10 Starlink missions." According to SpaceX, Transporter 6 had delivered about 114 payloads to the orbit for dozens of paying customers, making it the second largest rideshare mission ever launched. They further stated that the 114 payloads on the flight include CubeSats, MicroSats, PicoSats, and orbital transfer vehicles carrying spacecraft to be deployed at a later time. This time, Transporter mission included a number of interesting payloads. Out of the 114 payloads, almost three dozen of them were Earth-observing CubeSats, SuperDoves, developed and operated by Planet, a San Francisco-based company. Six satellites from Virginia-based space analytics company Spire Global were also part of this mission. EOS Sat-1, one satellite of the agriculture-focused constellation planned by EOS Data Analytics, was also flown in this mission. As per sources, the constellation will have seven satellites in all, and EOS Sat-1 was the first of them. EOS DA CEO Artyom Anisimov stated in a briefing that, "This launch brings new, game-changing possibilities of satellite technologies to the agricultural industry." EOS DA will now work with proprietary datasets to provide even deeper and more accurate insights for its customers and partners. Other than this, a French startup, Gamma, in partnership with Nano Avionics, have sent their first solar sail prototype through the SpaceX mission. The aim of this solar sail project is to find out whether it can be used for lowering the cost of deep space propulsion and exploration. An Earth observation satellite from Orbital Sidekick was also sent. While Link Global launched an in-space cell tower to test the ability to broadcast 5G from space to the ground, on the other hand, Skycraft, an Australian startup, launched their first batch of Block 2 air traffic management satellites and deployed their satellites with their custom-built space tug without propulsion named Deployer 1. Being an affordable launch option, SpaceX Rideshare drew a good number of space startups. As per sources, Transporter 6 deployed a number of space tugs developed by five startups. Among them, firstly, comes Launcher with their first-ever orbiter space tug. Then comes Epic Aerospace with their Chimera space tug, followed by Vigo Ride space tug from Momentus, which is powered by an exotic water plasma propulsion system, and remaining are two D-orbit ion space tugs. In the present space launch scenario, space tugs, though in their initial phase, is slowly gaining currency. Their main purpose is to deploy satellites launched as rideshare payloads from their rocket's parking orbit to a better optimized orbit. These tugs let operators send their satellites to a wide variety of orbits and still taking advantage of the savings enabled by rideshare launches, mainly from SpaceX. And it's estimated that using space tug services could enable routine changes on the order of hundreds or even thousands of kilometers for multiple payloads per flight. As for now, a tug built by spaceflight had already proved to raise orbit from 300 kilometers to more than 1,000 kilometers. Rocket Lab has even claimed that their photon tug can deliver payloads even to the moon. Keeping in mind its use future, space startups have started working on it. Max Hout, CEO of Launcher, stated that their company had realized that there was a big market opportunity to develop a space tug after SpaceX debuted their rideshare program, which dramatically lowered the cost of launch. Sources state that Launcher's orbital tug will be able to deploy or host payload for 10 separate customers. He also stated that they're developing a small launcher, of which Orbiter will be the third stage. Other than these space tugs, a UK-based startup named MagDrive has also sent their in-orbit tech demonstration to the Transporter 6 mission. The demonstration included a high-thrust spacecraft propulsion engine developed by them. Report says that the prototype propulsion system will be powered by solar panels attached to it. MagDrive CEO Mark Stokes stated, "The mission lasts 12 months, but we'll be aiming to try as many charge and discharge options as soon as possible so we get as much data as we can." Till now, with the completion of Transporter 6 mission, SpaceX has successfully delivered nearly 566 payloads to orbit in less than 2 years. And with the 100 launch goal in hand, we can easily expect to see a few more rideshare missions to be carried out in 2023. Today, we'll wrap up with an update regarding launch of Weather Imaging CubeSat of Space Force. Recently, on the 3rd of January, the U.S. Space Systems Command had launched a special CubeSat that's meant for validating multiple commercial weather imaging technologies that will be used by U.S. Army in the future. It's worth noting that this launch was part of the same SpaceX Transporter 6 rideshare mission that we mentioned a little bit before. For the last few decades, the U.S. Defense Department is collecting data from their age-old Defense Meteorological Satellite Program, or popularly known as DMSP satellites. But as per some reports, those are now lacking fuel and nearing towards their end of operation. And as sources state, they'll be put out of service in between the time slot of 2023 and 2026. So finding a backup is very necessary. For this reason, the U.S. government asked both Air Force and the Space Force to look into commercial market for alternatives that can replace the DMSP satellites. Later, through the Electro-Optical Infrared Weather System, or EWS program, Orion Space Solutions and General Atomics were chosen. And under this program, Orion Space Solutions have developed a CubeSat that was launched with the Transporter 6 mission. According to Space Force, they'll now assess the capabilities of the imaging CubeSat over a year-long demonstration to provide timely weather imagery data from low Earth orbit. If it's successful, then it can easily take place of DMSP satellites. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.